Hello, my dear student. Hope you are fine and taking care of yourself and doing practice for all the ray diagrams and numericals as well. You know that we are doing chapter light. So today we are going to start our new topic of the chapter light only. Before starting the topic, please do like and subscribe my channel and press the bell icon button for further notification. So let's start the topic. In mirror case, you have seen that when we are having either plane mirror or concave mirror, what we have observed in case of mirror, when we are having plane mirror, incident ray falls on it, and when it strikes to the mirror surface, then it bounces back into the same medium. Means we have given this name to this phenomena is reflection. What is the name we have given to this phenomena? Reflection. And at this point we have drawn the normal also, that is angle I, angle R, angle of incidence and angle of reflection. But what happens when a ray of light enters from one transparent medium to another? When a ray of light enter, like we are having this interface media, this is air and this medium is glass, another transparent medium. Here the medium is air only, but it bounces back to the same medium. But what happens when it enter from medium 1 to medium 2? Different medium. So when a ray falls obliquely to this, like this, if a ray falls obliquely to this, so the interface of two media, that is the surface of the two media. So at that point, when we draw the normal, or when it is a normal, so it, when it enter from air to glass, it bend towards the normal. And this is normal, and N dash A, this point is O, so AO is incident ray, and let us say that it is B. So OB is refracted ray. What happened, what you are watching, actually it is bending towards the normal. If you will extend this ray, this is original path. This is original path. Light have to go from this path. But what happened due to the change in medium, it bent towards the normal. Later on I will explain to you in the next videos that why it happens, it is due to the optical density. Just here I am telling you that air to glass, actually just like we are having mass density, similarly all the transparent mediums have their optical density. Whose optical density is more, it means they are more denser medium. So what happened, it bent towards the normal. So this is I and this is R. Means the light ray changes its path when it enter from one transparent medium to another transparent medium, it changes its path. This phenomena, it can bend towards the normal as well as if it will go from glass to air. It not necessarily always come from air to glass. It can go from glass to air also. So when it will go from glass to air, so it bends away. Like this is the original path. So this is R angle and this is I angle. So it bends away from its path. So it all depends due to the change in speed of light. Here the speed of light remains the same, but when it enter from one transparent medium to another transparent medium, here angle I is greater than angle R, or here angle I is less than angle R. What is angle I? Angle I is angle of incidence. And what is angle R? Angle R is angle of refraction here. So what is this refraction? This refraction is the new phenomena. Earlier we have done reflection, now we are talking about refraction. What is refraction? Refraction is the bending of the light rays when it enter from one transparent medium to another transparent medium at the interface of two media. Medium means two medium. At the interface of two media, when it falls obliquely, is known as refraction. Again, I am repeating, the bending of the light rays when it enter from one transparent medium to another transparent medium obliquely at the interface of two media is known as refraction. Here, what we have said in reflection, bouncing back of the light into the same medium. But here, what happened? Bending of the light rays. So this refraction phenomena we see in our daily life also. You have seen in a tumbler, in a glass or in a tumbler, you have seen when you put a lemon, then it actually appear to be bigger. So this is due to the refraction of light. Moreover, in a glass, transparent glass, if you will put a water and you just, water becomes another medium, here is air, here is water, and if you will put a stick in this, instead of coming straight from interface of this media, it appears to be bent like this. Spoon also you can take at your home, you can check. You can put the water into the water in a glass, transparent glass, and you can fill with water half and put a spoon inside it. Instead of stick, you can put the spoon also. The spoon appears to be bent. Where it appears to be bent? Where the interface media is present, means where the air and water contact is there. Instead of water, you can take any another oil, any another liquid. So these all phenomena, wherever the size appear different, these all phenomena we see in our daily life. Instead of lemon, we can put egg also. Moreover, some activities are given in your book, like in a bucket, or you have seen, like on a paper, alphabets are written or anything is written. Clear? On this, when will you put a paper weight made up of glass? So these alphabets appears to be raised or bigger. You have seen it also many times at your home also. Ki on a paper, if you will put any paper weight which is made up of glass. Okay? So the alphabet which are below that, they appears to be bigger or raised. Raised and bigger. So due to this refraction phenomena, things appear to be bigger. Virtually image around them appear. So they all happens due to the refraction phenomena. So what we can say that these are the phenomena which we observe in our daily life related to refraction. So according to that, then comes laws of refraction. Laws of refraction. What are the laws of refraction? As you can say that laws of refraction, you can simply, I can, laws of refraction. So let us do laws of refraction. What does it say? Laws of refraction. Earlier we have done reflection. Now laws of reflection we have done earlier. Now laws of refraction. What does it state? As you are watching, this is the incident ray. As you can see that this is the incident ray. What is this? It is refracted ray. It is refracted ray. And what is this? This is normal ray. So what is this law? First law, the incident ray, refracted ray, normal ray, all lie on the same plane at the point of incidence for the interface of two media. Means the incident ray, normal ray and refracted ray for a two medium at the point of incidence all lie on the same plane. What is second law? This angle you are watching, this angle you are watching. This angle is angle of incidence. This angle is angle of refraction this time. I have written earlier, ki angle R is angle of refraction here. Because phenomena change, so name also change of the angle. So here it is the angle of refraction. So what is this law? It says that it is the ratio of sine of angle of incidence to the sine of angle of refraction is constant. This law was given by Snell. So that's why this is also known as Snell's law. This is also known as Snell's law. The ratio of, there directly we have said in reflection, angle I is equal to angle R in reflection. But here it is not equal. They are different. So we have to take in terms of their sine. Sine of angle I to the sine of angle of refraction is constant for a given pair of media. And this constant is given the name refractive index. Whenever you will put the angles value like sine 30 degree, or this is, let us say this is 60 degree, or let us take this is 45 degree. So when will you substitute these values? Sine 60 degree upon sine 45 degree. So when will you put these values, you will get a constant here. And that constant is known as refractive index. So later on we will continue with these all topics. Today you will revise about refraction, laws of refraction, and where, what are the application of these laws of refraction, refraction in our daily life. Thank you and have a nice day.